In this video, we will see how to use Google Trends to see the demand patterns that exist for any niche. This is simply the best way to see how demand for products in a niche varies over the course of a year. The URL you need to go to is google.com/trends. Let us now see what kind of demand pattern you should expect to see if you are building a site selling golf balls. You type in golf balls into the text box at the top of the screen and push enter. While looking up information on trends on any topic, you want to make sure you select United States from the drop-down. It's the US market your affiliate sites will most likely be targeting. What you're now seeing is historical demand over the past 10 years or so. While the graph does not tell you how many searches per month the phrase golf balls gets, it does show you the trends. And the demand seems to be going down with time. We will discuss why this may be so later, but right now, let's look at what the demand was in 2015. The number of searches per month is on the y-axis, which is the vertical, and time is on the x-axis, which is the horizontal. You would want to note that the number of searches per month is not displayed here. You will need to use Google AdWords Keyword Planner to get to know that. We will get to that part later. We'll stick with Google Trends now. You can see the demand reaches its peak in summer and then falls during the winter months before peaking again in December and then falls steeply until the next summer. This is kind of what you would expect. Now, let's try to see what the pattern is like for Callaway Golf Balls, which is a very popular brand of golf balls. You can see the demand pattern is virtually identical to what we found for the niche golf balls. If you were to build a site about golf balls, you would expect to make the most sales in the summer months, around June and July. Then, the sales would fall during the winter months. Sales would rise again during December, which is this period here. You could also be sure of one thing. Your site will be making sales all around the year. There is no discontinuity or break in the graph. So golf balls sell all year round, but the demand is more in the summer months and during December. So sales will be maximum during these 3 or 4 months of the year, but you will have sales all year long. You can see the same is true for Nike golf balls as well. Let's now check what the graph looks like for golf clubs. You can see the pattern is very similar to golf balls. The demand is maximum during the summer months and much lower rest of the year. The thing you would want to note is that the demand for golf clubs does not peak in December. It actually seems very low in December. I do not know anything about golf. If you are someone who knows the niche inside out, you would be able to tell why this occurs. Now, let's take a look at something entirely different. Raincoat. Let's see what the pattern looked like in 2015. As you can see, demand exists throughout the year, but it peaks in late September and early October and stays high for the rest of the year. On the other hand, for diamond rings, the demand hits a high in mid-February, which is around Valentine's Day, and then falls a bit. It increases again during late November and early December. For gold certificates, the demand is high throughout the year. If you had an affiliate site selling gold certificates or something related to gold certificates, you could expect to see a steady stream of sales throughout the year. Now, let's look at kitchen faucets. The demand for kitchen faucets is more or less constant for the entire year. But come December, the demand shoots up and stays the way till early January. Likewise, the demand for kitchen islands is more or less constant for the entire year and then increases very significantly during late December and early January. You can see the graph is almost vertical during late December. The pattern is similar for kitchen knives. The only difference is demand starts increasing significantly in late November and stays high for the rest of the year. The graph for hair dye is kind of interesting. Demand is high for most of the year, but there is a surprising drop in mid-November and it stays low until late December. I do not know why this is so. The only guess I have is this. During late November and early December, people are so caught up in preparing for Christmas. They are booking air tickets, buying presents and all that, and they have no time to think about dyeing their hair. But when it's actually time to meet their relatives, they rush to buy hair dye, which is why the demand increases so significantly just before Christmas. This might or might not be true, but that is the only explanation I can think of. The graph for bathing suits is just what you would expect. The demand is very low in early spring. It starts increasing in March. Then it nosedives during April. Colleges have their exams at this time, and most people have no time to think about bathing suits and vacations. The demand reaches its maximum in the summer months and then falls steeply. Winter is here and no one is interested in wearing bikinis at the beach now. Now, let's take a look at the graph for prom dresses. Demand is high during the months of January to April and demand falls steeply after that. It's very low for the rest of the year and starts rising again during late December. If you had a site selling prom dresses that made $1,000 a month in April, you would be lucky if it made $200 in June. Let's now see the graph for Halloween costumes. The demand for Halloween costumes exists only during mid-August to October. For about 11 weeks. If you had a niche site that sold only Halloween costumes and nothing else, it would make money only during 11 weeks of the year. For the rest of the year, it would have near zero revenues. Now, that is not necessarily a bad thing. There are a lot of people who build sites that generate revenues only for a few weeks in a year. All I'm saying is, this should not be a surprise for you. If you are going into a niche like this, a niche that is seasonal, you should do so while being fully aware that your site will be generating revenues only for a few weeks or months during the year. This should not come as a surprise to you. If you have taken the time to study the demand patterns for a niche before you build the site, you will know what the graph looks like and what you can expect. There will be no surprises. You will be fully aware. Similarly, the demand for Easter eggs exists only during March. For the rest of the year, demand is very low. By now, you should have a pretty good understanding of why you need to check if a niche is seasonal. In the next video, we will take a close look at another very important thing to check: regional interest.